Welcome back, everybody. Let's play. Oh, okay. So let's play Nicktoons Unite. Last episode. Is that like a? Oh, I thought that was a little atom icon, like during Neutron's Luger for a moment, in green. Last time we just made more progress here in Bikini Bottom. We found Patrick, but now he's kind of gone. He got sucked up and away. So I need to retrieve him. Exactly a surprise, but. But we also stumbled upon something peculiar on our way there. That being. Go away. That being this rather mysterious large green ship, or maybe not so mysterious. But whose voice actor we apparently cannot get for this video game. Hi, Mr. Dutchman. I like how a lot of characters in the SpongeBob series have just kind of resigned to being completely uninvolved with anything involving SpongeBob if given the chance. I'm afraid you're stuck with me again. SpongeBob kind of, he acts like he secretly knows that everybody has taken this attitude towards him too. See, Danny's the diplomat. Well, I guess you kind of do. Well, you don't really make them do it you tell them to do. You just kind of, like, physically force them to be somewhere. You have a crew of 6 people. Whatever you say, and SpongeBob was floating, because why not? The glowing effect here is cool, at least. Does every level have to involve collecting a certain number of things? Because that seems to be a thing that happens by the level. Why is my circle messed up? What happened to my circle? Danny's circle deserves more respect than this. What happened to my circle? I have a skewed circle. This is a disgrace. Oh. Oh, my circle's okay now. Anyways. So, I'm just kind of in the middle of nowhere, in Bikini Bottom, amongst green grass fields. We find a big sea of green goo. Home to ghosts. Kind of peculiar. I really do like, though, that they actually kind of added to the whole crossover quality of things. So I'm hiding a chest. Why would you hide yourself in a chest? Actually. So if this guy phases out, I can do that. Awesome. No. Don't you do that. I just kind of, like, killed him. I never really specified that he wanted his crew members back functional. I do like how they actually draw parallels between Danny Phantom, oops, and the whole ghost thing, and the Flying Dutchman, and his crew. Why isn't there a thing up here? There should be a thing up here. Which is cool. Oh, okay. That's a nice detail, at least. Something nice that they caught on to. So that's one of those things I can say they did well in this game, I think. I mean, as much. Wait, what just happened? Sonic, what just happened? So it looks like right as I was talking about the game having its good parts, I'm stuck. Well. Nope, there we go. Right as I was talking about the game having its good parts, I'm stuck again. I discovered that. Danny, stop doing that. I seem to discover, unless I just did things wrong, which I might have, that there seems to be... Yep. There's no floor there. Okay. And right now, as I was saying, as much as I chastise this game, it does have good parts to it, and that is why I like it. Aside from just having, like, made a certain series happen that I happen to like. But no, then, right as I was interrupted in speaking that sentence, whoops, by finding... I was interrupted on saying that by falling through the floor. The timing in this game is impeccable. It's like it's trying to send me a message saying, no, don't love me. I don't deserve it. And maybe it's right. I'm gonna play it anyways. Go away, ghost. Oh, come on. Do I actually have to use Danny to, not Danny. Do I actually have to use... Oh darn, I can't possess the ghost. It seems like I actually have to use, Jimmy to... leave me alone! Take this guy out, because... Otherwise he's just intangible forever. Anyways, that little adventure aside, with a lack of physics. We still have some more collecting to do. You think they could make things, try to make things a little bit less monotonous, though? With the whole placing every single... Placing every single, enemy you have to find into the same... Whoa. Into the same container you just walk up to and break open. Okay, look, I appreciate the power pickups, but health is nice too. Wait, why is there actually, like, clean water here? It seems to be kind of a scarcity. I probably should have had Jay pick that up, because he's the one I'm using the most right now. At least in situations that involve getting hurt, he's the one I'm using the most. This game really does go easy on you when it makes things like health respawn. Respawning resources in general, really, are just kind of a mark of a game being made to be easy. But even more... SpongeBob, you floating nub. But even more so when, those things that respawn are health. Oh god, Jimmy. Anyways. Timmy, are you just kind of like scared or something? Of the ship? Get over here. Whatever. He just refuses. Oh, here he is. No, wrong. Eat air gusts. Foul beast. And then he went away. And I'm being told to press square and there's nothing to do- Oh, and then I was stuck again. You get caught on things really easily in this game. There's a thing down here. Wait, a health pickup that I don't need. That's surprisingly common. Why does this air burst thing work? Why can the AI... There we go. The AI can jump up there, but I can't. Whatever. We're almost done, at least. I believe. I think the next crew member is on the next ship. If not, I think he's off to the right on land. I'll have to see. Boom. You're also doing the same thing every time you fight these guys. Yes, because they always use the same tactics. You have to hit them with a specific attack and attack them some more. How do I get down there? That made me curious, game. And what's off to the right here, too? Because there's land here for me to go on. There's absolutely nothing except for a small structure mimicking a building, but a very small size for no clear reason. Oh, okay. That somehow opens that. Explosion of monies! I don't know why games like to do that, making money fly everywhere whenever it's dropped. That's kind of comical. And to a degree, satisfying. As you get to chase everything as it goes everywhere. It's one of those simple pleasures in life, I guess, in some weird way. Are enemies gonna spawn everywhere, or am I just gonna get to take life easy? I guess I'm gonna get to take life easy. What's up? See how these AIs are jumping? They just go where they want to go. There you go, teamwork. Don't go away. Yay. Well, I wasn't really cursed yet. Whatever. Yeah, so sometimes those just simple pleasures in video games, or life in general, I guess. We just kind of... Can I destroy that, please? Okay, I can't. That's very dissatisfying. Where there's not much explanation to liking something the way you do, but sometimes it's just so satisfying. Sometimes pressing a simple button can be so satisfying. Push, push. Push, push. Like the square button. Mr. Dutchman. Well, okay. Oh, that's... That's a roundabout way of getting somewhere. I have 9 lives. When did I get all those? Anyways, I wanted to improve SpongeBob's. Oh, reduces the power cost of the charge tech. No, I don't want that. What's the upgrade for this? Charge! But I don't like careful charge attacks on any of these things. I don't find charge attacks useful. I don't really use enough of these abilities ever to actually want to upgrade them to decrease their power usage either. The thing is, then, that's literally all of the upgrades if I do that. So then I have nothing to spend my points on. So I guess I might as well spend my point on something, but now it's going to feel useful. Shrink ray already has its usage decreased. I guess I could decrease the cost of, yeah, these things. And decreasing the cost is at least somewhat useful. Let's go. Gary! Gary's snail trail doesn't usually look like that. It's not that green. It just looks like water. It's an inaccuracy. That's not what Gary's food bowl looks like either.
We need to shut this factory down. We can't let the syndicate collect any more energy from these jellyfish.
From the look of these plans, There are 4 emergency vents that we should be able to release the jellyfish through.
What plans?
That ought to do it.
Wait.
Oh, those.
What's that noise?
Patrick! Hooray! Don't worry, buddy. We'll have you out of there in a jiffy.
Okay, I'll admit, when I first played... Oh, hey, I'm automatically Danny. That's cool. When I first played... I guess that's because I was Danny earlier. This level. And I saw... Well, I guess I'll have to get to it first before I... Yep! There we go. It gets to the point where it's not even funny anymore. It's just kind of sad. It's kind of funny again sometimes when you find new ways in which that sort of thing happens, but even still. And we can't turn that thing because... dumb, so... I will admit... I first played this stage, and I saw... Keep in mind, this was a long time ago, but when I first played the stage, I saw that pink star right there in this room containing Patrick. I completely forgot about the fact that that corresponds to Timmy, and I just assumed that that was an upgrade for Patrick, which was kind of weird since he's not normally playable, but I searched for a way to free Patrick so I could actually bring him to here. And it would make sense if it was an upgrade for Patrick too, for him to be able to do something that requires strength, that being turning a valve, but... left. But basically, now you can do this. So now you can turn things. Why not? I think it lets you pick up such certain things too. And he's gonna say that every single time you switch that weapon too, which is a bit old after a little while. Now that that's up, we can platform our merry way across. But there are more things to be seen first. It's a grand... Where is that? There. Darn depth perception. There's a grand new world out here waiting to be seen. With words like these ones. Oh, I see. Timmy. I also... all the focus on Timmy all of a sudden. I thought this place was SpongeBob's deal. So, normally, Patrick... Timmy just... Danny just kind of teleported. See, normally Patrick just kind of stops there and can't run across until you make that raise upwards. But then he'll just run on across, and then certain polygons will just disappear. He also runs with his arms out to his side, like a cowboy or something for some reason. Ready to draw his pistol, six shooter, whatever it'd be called. And for some reason I want to suddenly start talking about old dueling pistols, but that's a little bit irrelevant. Ow, explosions to the face. Shut up, Patrick. Like, he also just keeps... Stop it, Patrick. He also just keeps saying that for some reason. Stop saying those words, Timmy. That's a really odd non-Patrick thing for Patrick to say, too. I can't get past. That's very oddly... articulate? Be quiet! Whoever decided that he should use that line is somebody that I don't think should have the credit they're being given. Because that's a very not Patrick line. And making people say things that their characters would say is generally a pretty important thing to keep in mind. So thankfully, this lever does not require... the special abilities of a chin. How do I get up there? Was there something I destroyed that I had to jump on to get up there? I think there was. It's unfortunate if so. Go away. Oh nice, it's one of these teleporting guys again that make enemies. I despise these guys at Vlad's castle. Although this one's been taken care of already, so whatever.
I need some help over here, people. I can't get past.
That I need some help over here thing at least sounds vaguely Patrick-like. People. What say you about the Bunsen murder? Sure. Quiet! And there are radioactive materials here, too. Okay, seriously. Patrick! Please! Okay, where's the water? Oh, there's water here, for some reason. There's not. This thing needs to catch fire. Could you please catch fire? How do you make that catch fire? I don't quite remember. The only one that... We need to, like, inverse the fire. Yes, I could make water come out of it, but I don't remember how to do that. Oh, wait. There we go. And remember not to walk off the ledge, because you'll end up losing all your water if you do. Okay. Just because you won't be quiet, Patrick, I'm going to take this one out first. From the wrong side entirely, but it works nonetheless. Patrick, please. Could they at least make him repeat those lines less often? I mean... It's kind of clear already, I think, that you need to have Patrick come with you to get somewhere. So I don't think you need the constant reminder of him saying words. Do those doors just magically open once you have Patrick with you? Seems kind of weird. I was just standing there, unable to move for a little bit. I was getting kind of paranoid as to what that meant for continuing the level, since I'd come to expect the worst of this game in some ways. Which I'm kind of sad to be able to say. Why does teleporting hurt me? Okay, look, you're just creating more upgrade points for me. Useless, useless upgrade points. Why does this guy keep respawning? I find those characters annoying simply just because they keep teleporting around and then respawning. So you have to keep running around killing them if you want them to just be gone. But then you're never fully satisfied because they don't always disappear afterwards. Patrick, can we get the... Oh, I see there's a path leading up to there. What? No, there's a wall there. I was wondering, is there a wall there, or is there just a giant gap for no reason? Well, there are coins to be picked up, if anything. I'm confident it's just not... What? Okay. Okay. Well then. I'm kind of tempted to not pick these up since, like I said, I don't really see there being also any use for them. For me. Okay, I can't climb up these pipes for some reason. That's totally a thing that a video game director would do, though. Or an actual person, too. I know, I'm not picking those coins up. I'm protesting them. How do we just... I'm not sure if you're required to use stamina for these jumps or not, but might as well. I start turning the machine off. This doesn't sound like Patrick at all. Why does Patrick know about this? They're really not emulating Patrick's stupidity in this game at all, I don't think. Original... okay, I went away. Original silliness, whatever you might want to call it. The jellyfish is kind of stuck now. Not sure if that's much better or worse than the predicament they're already in. Whoops, I mean to do that. But anyways, I guess I'll be seeing you guys next time, next episode of Let's Play Nicktoons Unite, where we find all the emergency valves for the vents. With a rather well-spoken Patrick. Why is there an invisible wall right here? Why couldn't they give me those extra 2 meters of movement? Well, I'll see you guys next time when we discover what more ways this game is going to disappoint me in. See you then, guys.